Everyone, I am Afsha Kareen, Maths Faculty in Tala Padmavati International School. Today, we are going to deal with Class 2, Chapter 2, Counting in Groups. Topic, Representation of Numbers in Different Forms. So children, in the previous sessions, we have learned the order of the number. Before number, after number, between number and the missing numbers. And also we have learned how to form the biggest and the smallest number. In this video, we are going to see the representation of number in different forms. Let us see what are the different forms. The first form is standard form. Please children, repeat along with me. Standard form. The second one is word form. The third one is knowing the place value. The fourth one is beads form. And the last one is expanded form. So children, these are the topics which we are going to cover in our today's video. Let us start with what is standard form. Standard form is something which gives a representation of a number. So 86. The number representation is said to be in standard form. So children, 86 is written in the standard form, the numeral representation is called as standard form. So any number is a numeral, right? And the numeral representation is also called as standard form. The standard form is something not which I have discovered or something anyone has discovered. It is nothing but children, the numerical form. Numerical means what? Numbers. So, standard form is nothing but the number representation. The number representation is called as standard form. Can you tell me some other example of standard form? What did you say? 9. Still? 72. 55. 85. 25, 0, 6, 8, 11. So these all numbers are represented as standard form. The numeral form is called as standard form. So next one is word form. What is word form? What is mean by word? What is mean by word? Children, word is nothing but spelling, right? So, the spelling of the number, the numbers which are written in the form of words. Using words we rewrite. For example, we have 98. We write in spellings. N-I-N-E-T-Y, 90, E-I-G-H-T-8. We are using words to write the number. So, such representation is called as words form. Now, let us see an example. For example, children, 95. 95 is which form? Standard form. Now, I have to write this standard form into word form. In words means in spellings. So 90. N-I-N-E-T-Y. 90. F-I-V-E 5. 95. This is the standard form. This is the word form. Now children, We shall see one more example. Come on, give me an example. Give me any standard number. 23. This is the standard form. Now, tell me the word form with spellings. TWENTY. FIVE. 25. So this is the word form of the given number. Now children, let us see word form to standard form, standard form to word form. So let us continue with this number. 23 is which form, children? Very good, standard form. Now I need to write word form. 20, TWENTY. 20, THREE. 23. Now 48. In which form I have given the question? Very good. I have given the question in word form. Now you need to tell me the standard form of the number. Come on, tell me children. 48. Is it correct? Now let us see some textbook bits on standard form and word form. So children, what is the question? Write in words. So what is given? Which form is given? Numeral or standard form is given. Now I need to write the word form. So what is the spelling? SIXTY 60, FOUR 4, 64. 64 is the word form. This is the numeral form. 72, I need to write the word form. SEVENTY 70, TWO 2, 72. 98. Many of the children do mistake with this spelling, but children, NINE TY 90, EIGHTH 98. Next one is 89, EIGHT 80, NINE 9. Remaining four, you are going to write. For 58, you are going to write the word form. 45, you are going to write the word form. For 34, you are going to write the word form. And for 26, you are going to write the word form and practice. Let us see the next bit. Write in numerals. So here they have given the word form, children. 46. They have given in spellings. That means they have given in words. Now we need to write in numerals. 46 means 4, 6. 88. 8 and 8 makes 88. 25. 2, 5. 25. 17. 1, 7. 17. Next one. 97. 97. So this is how we have converted the numerical form to the word form and the word form to the numerical form. Now let us see a match the following. 42. 42 is the numerical form. Now children, search the word form. 31, 28, 17, 42. So here it's a match. 68. The next one is 68. Next, 95. Next one, 74. Here we go, 74. 17. Here it is. 17. 28. And the next one is 31. So children, in this way, you can practice the numerical form as well as the number names of it, which is nothing but word form of the number. So our next form is place value. Children, what is place value? Place value is something which represents the value of a digit in its number. Let us consider an example. For example, you are sitting in first bench in your classroom. So it is, the value of you is first bencher, right? If you, the same person, if you go and sit in the last bench, what your value becomes? Your value becomes the last bencher, isn't it? So whenever a number is in one's place, its value is represented in one's form. When the number is in tens place, its value represented in tens form. So what I want to say here is, a value of a number is not same, children, always. The value of the number changes with its place. If it is in ones place, it has different value. If the same 5 is in tens place, the value is different. Now let us see what is mean by ones. Ones means what, children? Ones means one, right? This is one, right? This is one. This token is one. These all are ones. Okay, single digit, single object is represented as ones. Ones, ones, ones. These all are ones. So what are the numbers which are ones? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These all are ones, children. Then what is mean by tens? And how tens is formed? And what is the value of tens? As I told you, ones is nothing but one. Right? In the same way, children, when I have 10 ones, let us pick 10 marbles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here I have 10 wooden slabs, individual. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Till 9, they are ones. But 10 ones makes 110. So the value of tens is, what is the value of tens, children? So the value of tens is 10. Now you see, ones is 1 and tens means 10 ones makes 110. Now let us consider a two-digit number, 39. So children, how we are going to know which is ones place and which is tens place? Always remember, any addition, any subtraction is done from ones place, and it starts from right side. So this side, this represented as ones. What is the value at ones place? 9. What is the value at tens place? Come on, children. 3. Let us pick some other number. What I told you? Ones and tens. And ones always starts from right side, children. Not from 3. 3 is not ones. It is wrong.
2 is ones. What is in ones place? 2. What is in tens place? 3. Let us see another example. 95. What is in ones place? 5. What is in tens place? 9.
Now, let us pick another number. 26.
So children, here I have represented ones is equals to 1 and tens is equals to 110. I have represented by 10 ones. Okay. Now I want to show you 26 in the form of this representation.
So first of all, tell me what is in ones place.
Come on. Yes. In ones place we have 6. What is in tens place? 2. So ones is nothing but 6 individuals. No, no, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Shall we recall the poem? 1, 1, ones, 2, ones, 2, 3, ones, 3, 4, ones, 4, 5, ones, 5, 6, ones, 6, 7, ones, 7, 8, ones, 8, 9, ones, 9, 10, ones, 10. So, 6 ones, how much? 6. I have picked 6 bars. Now, to represent 2 tens. Do you remember the 10 table? 1, 10, 10. 2, 10, 20, 3, 10, 30, 4, 10, 40, 5, 10, 50, 6, 10, 60, 7, 10, 70, 8, 10, 80, 9, 10, 90, 10, 10, 100. So children, here what is in the place of 2? This is which place? Tens place. So I need to take 2, 10, 20. This is a group of 10. Again, I should take one more group of 10. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is the bar representation. This is the slabs bar representation of 26. 1, 10. 2, 10. How much? 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 26.
Now let us take some more examples and know what is the place value of the given digits. Come on children, pick any number. 42. So as I told you, from the right side, it is ones place. Ones and tens. So place value of 2. What is the place value of 2, children? 2 ones. 2 ones are 2. What is the place value of 4? 4 tens? T. Let's take another number. 35. So children, tell me from where is this place ones? No. From the right side it is ones and this is tens. So what is the place value of 5? 5 ones. 5 ones. 5. 5 ones. 5. Now what is the place value of tens? 3. At which place? Tens place. 3 tens. 30. Can we see one more example? And the last one, this is 85. What is in ones place? Very good. What is in tens place? 8. 5 ones, 5 8 tens 80. Now let us do some textbook bits. So children, whenever a number is given, you need to write the place values, ones and tens. So as I'm writing, ones, tens, always try to follow this. Ones, tens. So it will be very easy for you to solve the given question. Now the question is, encircle the numbers that have digit 6 at ones place. So we have to see the ones place and it should be 6 in ones place. So what we have in 28 in ones place? 8. So 1 6, what we have in one place? 6. So this is the number, we need to circle this. 42, do it have 6 in ones place? No. 66, do it has 6 in ones place? Yes. 85 has 6 in ones place? No. 96 has 6 in ones place? Yes. 14 has 6 in ones place? No. Does 26 has 6 in ones place? Yes. Now, encircle the numbers that have 7 at tens place. What is the first thing which I asked you to do? Write the place values below. So that it will be very easy for us. Ones, O represent ones, T represent tens. Now we shall see. 7 in tens place, beta. Do we have 7 in tens place in 82? No. Do we have 7 in tens place in 72? Yes. Do we have 7 in tens place in 62? Mm-hmm. Do we have 7 in tens place in 79? Yes. Do we have 7 in tens place in 88? 98? No. In 84, in tens place, 7. No. In 76, yes, there is 7 in tens place. Do I have 7 in one tens place? No. Now again, ones, tens. This is a basic thing you should always do whenever we are given with a number. Okay, now encircle the number that the digit has 2 at ones place. We should see 2, but in which place? Ones place. Does it has? No. Will you do this for me as a homework? So take bit number 3 and 4 as homework and ones, tens. See, you can see this thing. In this you need to see the number 2 in ones place. In this question you need to see 7 in tens place. Bit 3 and bit 4 you can take as homework. Now let us see the next question. Write any 5 numbers that have digit 4 in ones place. Oh my god. We need to write 4 numbers which have 4 in ones place. 14 has 4 in ones place. 24, yes. 44, yes. 94, yes. 84. Was that easy? Now you need to tell me numbers which have 8 at tens place. So the numbers should start with 8. 85, 89, 86, 87, 88. Check children,
1's tens. Do we have 18 tens place? Yes. 18 tens place? Yes. 18 tens place? Yes. 18 tens place? 18 tens place. Let us see the last bit. Fill in the blanks. One has been done for you. 1's place, 8 tens place. So what I told you again, same thing. 1's tens, 1's sentence, 1's sentence, and 1's sentence, and 1's sentence. So tell me what is in 1's place? 2 and tens place? 6. Don't hurry-burryly write 6 and 2. Because 6 is in tens place, children. And 2 is in 1's place. Now again, next question. Tell me what is in 1's place? 8, tens place, 7. Very good. 8, tens place, 9. 9, tens place, 4. Last one. 1's place, 1. Tens place, 5. So, I hope everyone are clear with the place values. Now let us see beats representation. So, what is beat form? Numbers represented in beats is called as beats form. So, here you can see the beats, children. And I have kept ones and tens place here. As I told you, right side is the ones place and this side it is the tens place. Now, let us pick up a random number and represent it in beats form. So, what is the number I got? 75. First of all, let us empty this. Here, my red beads are representing tens and my green beads are representing ones. So, children, when I want to represent 75, first of all, tell me what is in ones place. Is it 5 or is it 7? What is in ones place, children? Come on. Yes, 5. So, in ones place, I am going to show 5 beads. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That was easy. Next, what is in my tens place? My tens place. It is 7. So I am going to represent 1, 10, 10, 2, 10, 20, 3, 10, 30, 4, 10, 40. 5, 10, 50, 6, 10, 60, 7, 10, 70, 70, 7 tens, 70 plus 5. How much, children? 75. We shall pick one more number. Oh, where are the numbers? So, what is the number which I have picked? 16. 16. So, children, tell me what is in ones place? Is it 6 in ones place or 1 in ones place? Come on, tell me right side. Very good. 6 is in ones place. So, which are ones beads? Green beads are ones. So, 1, 1 ones, ones, 2 ones, 2, 3 ones, 3, 4 ones, 4, 5 ones, 5, 6 ones, 6, 7, 6 already, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 are enough. Now, how many tens? Only 1 ten. So, 1 and 6. How much? 1, 6, 16. Now, let us take the last example. What is the number I got? I got a 10. So, children, what is in 1's place? It's a zero. Zero means no bead. You need not keep any sort of bead. And what is in tens place? One. So this is 10. Children, I'll be putting the beads and you need to guess the number. Shall we do that? Okay. I'm trying to make it tough for you. Hopefully. Can you tell me what is the number? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 and 2. What it is? 42. Very good. Shall I give one more question? I'll be adding up this itself. Now can you tell me what is the number? This is ones, this is tens. Read the number from tens place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 and 1. What is the number? Very good. 61. So children, hope you'll try this beads form by drawing it. Now let us see expanded form. What is mean by expanded? Children, what is this? This is my hairband. So children, what is the actual meaning of expand? This is expanding, right or no? We are expanding the rubber band. So am I adding extra rubber in this? No. Am I removing it? Am I removing something from this rubber band? No. I'm expanding whatever rubber band is given for me. I'm just enlarging it and showing you. In the same way, number, for example, 36 is there. I'm not going to remove anything from this number. I'm not going to add something into this number. I'm just going to show you by writing this number in an expanded form by using the place values. So, what I told you? Ones and tens. Right? So, what is the place value of tens? Three tens? Come on. Very good. Three tens, 30. Plus, I'm just breaking the number, Nana. I'm just breaking the number. But the number is same. I'm not reducting it. I'm not adding it. What is the place value of ones? 6. 30 plus 6. Shall we add and see? Did I get the same number? Yes. Let us take another example. 54. Ones, tens. What is the place value of tens? 5 tens. 5 tens how much? 50. Plus 4 ones. 4. 50 plus 4 is again 54. So I am representing this number in an expanded form using their place value. Now let us see a textbook example. 20 plus 4, 24, 98, ones, tens. What is the place value of 9? 9, 10, 90. 8 ones, 8. Is it not easy, children? Next, ones, tens. What is the place value of 4 tens? 4 tens, 40, and 5 ones. 5. 40 plus 5 again, 45. This remaining 3, you take it as your homework and try to practice. So children, once again, how many forms we have learned today? Standard form, word form, beads form, place value, and also expanded form. So our next topic is comparison of numbers. We compare numbers and represent them
whether they are greater than, less than or equal to by using these symbols. So children, this is the greater than symbol, this is the equal to symbol and this is the less than symbol. There is a small trick for remembering these symbols. Like you get confused in these two. So what is this less than? What is the spelling of less? L-E-S-S. Right children? So L is towards this side. In the same way the symbol of less than will be open towards L. Like L, similar to L. In the same way the opposite of that is a greater than. So this is the less than which is like L and this is greater than which is opposite to the direction of less than. And anyhow equal to, you are familiar with equal to. Now children, whenever we are comparing single digit number, it is very much easy for us. Let us take an example. 2 and 9. When we are comparing two numbers children, we need to compare the first number with the second number. Never we are going to see 9 with 2. We are going to see 2 with 9. So as we already know the order of the numbers, we know that 2 comes first, then 9. So that 2 is less than 9. I'm not comparing 9 is greater than 2. I'm not going reverse. I'm always comparing the first come first serve. Who came first for me? 2 came first for me. And I'm comparing 2 with whom? I'm comparing 2 with 9. So 2 is greater than 9 or less than 9. We know using order of numbers that 2 comes first in numbers. So 2 is greater. Children, which is a greater than symbol? This is the greater than symbol. Right? This made very easy using single digits. Then what about two digit numbers children? Whenever we are having two digits number 23 and 45. We have already discussed the topic of place values. So children, before we compare the two numbers given, what is the number given? 23 and 45. Before we compare the numbers, let us write the place values of these. And place value starts from 1's place, 1's, 10's, 1's, 10's. Okay. So, whenever you are going to compare a number, compare its highest place value. So children, what is the highest place value here? The highest place value is 10th place, right? 2 and 4. What is here? 2 and 4. So let us write the digits even. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are our digits. Now children, my question is, compare the highest place value. Where is the highest place value? What is the highest place value of 23? 10th place. What is in 10th place? 2. And what is in 45 number 10th place? 4. So children, 2 is less than 4 or greater than 4? What do you think? It is before 4 children. So this is less than. Okay, but if there is a condition where both the tens places are same, both the tens places are same. I have 23, I have 25. 23 and 25, tens place equal. Shall I write equal symbol in between? No children, only tens place shouldn't be same. The complete number should be the same for the writing equal to. But here, tens place is same, but ones place is different. So, when we have same tens places, we need to go for the next place. The next place is ones place. So what it is, children? In ones place we have 3. In ones place we have 5. Now let us see here again. In ones place 3. In ones place 5. So 3 is less than 5 or greater than 5? Exactly. It is less than 5. So the number becomes, so the symbol which we use in between will be less than. Okay. Whenever we have same tens places, we go for the ones place. If a situation comes where ones place is also same, children, ones place is also same, then what is the symbol which we are going to use? Yes, 23 and 23. Tens place, ones place. Tens place, ones place. Both are same. So the symbol which we are going to use is equal to. So whenever we are comparing numbers, we need to compare the first number with the second number, then the tens place, then the ones place. Now let us see some textbook bits.
Insert greater than, less than, or equal to sign. So here they have given a pair of numbers to be compared. I already told you that first number to be compared with the second number, not the second number to be compared with the first number. And first foremost thing, what we need to do, we need to write the place values. Ones, tens. So children, what is in tens place in first number? One. What is in tens place in second number? 9. So children, 1 is less than 9 or greater than 9? Very good. It is less than 9. Next, ones, tens, ones, tens. What is in tens place? 3. What is in tens place? 3. 3 and 3 are same. So what we have to do? We have to go for ones place. What is in ones place? 8. What is in ones place? 8. So is this number equal, equal? Yes. So this makes equal, equal. Now, next question. Ones, tens, ones, tens. Don't get confused, children. Observe carefully. What is in tens place? 5. What is in tens place? 4. So 5 is more than 4 or less than 4? 5 is more than 4. So here we get greater than. Next one. Ones, tens, ones, tens. 81 and 18. Tens place 8. Tens place 1. So 8 is more than 1, children, or less than 1? More than 1. 28, 82. 2 and 8. 2 is more than 8 or less than 8? Come on, come on. Very good. It is less than 8. So children, you can pick up any pair of numbers from 1 to 100 and compare those and insert the symbol greater than, less than, or equal to. In comparison of numbers, our next topic which we are going to discuss is ascending order, descending order. Come on children, repeat along with me. Ascending order, descending order. What is mean by ascending order? Ascending order means arrangement of a number from small to big. Children, ascending, small, small to big. Descending order, big to small. Once again, along with me, children, ascending order means small to big. Descending order means big to small. So here you can see different signs of objects here. Let us first try with them the ascending order and descending order. So children, what is mean by ascending order? Very good. Small to big. So there is a ball, there is a ring, there is a piece of chalk. Which is small, children? Which is smallest? Yes, this piece of chalk is smallest. So I kept this piece of chalk first. And then, is this ball small or the ring small? Yes, the ring is small. And the last one, the ball. So this arrangement is said to be in ascending order. Small to big. Now let us arrange descending order. Descending order means big to small, and among these the big object is ball. So I have kept the ball. Next object is ring, and next object is piece of chalk. So this arrangement is from big to small. Descending order means big to small. In the similar way, children, now we are going to see ascending and descending order in numbers. First of all, let us pick three numbers from our 1 to 100 numbers and let us arrange them in ascending and descending order. So here the first number. Next, I would like to pick. Yeah, I went up for 26. And the last number which I have picked is 50. So here are three numbers. So children, few minutes before we have learned the comparison of numbers, how to compare the numbers using their place values. So we shall follow the same. So what are the numbers? 45, 26, 50. So what is in tens place? Tens. 4. What is in tens place? 2. What is in tens place? 5. So children, first of all, which order we are going to place? Ascending order. Ascending order means small to big. Now let us see. 4, 2, 5. Which number is small? 2. 4 or 5? Which number is small? 4. Is it not easy, children? In the last one, 50. So this is the ascending order of the numbers. Now let us take 4 numbers. We'll be picking 4 numbers, children. Okay. Now we shall arrange them in ascending order. Ascending order means again small to big. So tens place numbers. Only seeing tens place numbers we are going to see. What is tens place? 8. What is in tens place? 5. What is in tens place? 3. What is in tens place? 1. 8, 5, 3, 2, 3, 1. Which is small, children? 1 is small. So 10 comes first. 8, 5, 3. Which is small? 3. 8 or 5. Which is small? 5. And the least one? 8. So this is the ascending order of the given numbers. Now children, I will be picking up 5 numbers. Let us take 1, 2, 3, 4, and here we go, 5. Let us see what happens.
So here I have 5 numbers. So I should check which place? Tens place. 9, 6, 8, 6, 7. Which is small? 9, 6, 8, 7. I think 6 is small. But children, I have 2 numbers from 6. So I should go for the ones place. What is in ones place? 1. What is in ones place? 9. So 1 is small or 9 is small? 1 is small. So 1 will come first. Then will come 69. Then 9, 8, 7. What is small? Very good. 7. Then 8. Then 9. Is it not easy, children? Now let's just try a textbook exercise. Arrange in ascending order. So here you can see 6 digits. First of all, I'm going to underline tens places. 4, 1, 2, 4, 9, 6. So children, first of all, we will write ascending order means small to big. Small to big. Now 4, 1, 2, 4, 9, 6. Which is the smallest number? Is it 1? So I am writing 18. 1. So I will cut this. This number is completed. Next. 4, 2, 4, 9, 6. 1 after 2. 2 number also I have striked. 4, 4, 9, 6. So 4 is small or 6 is small, children? 4 is small, but 4 I have 2 numbers. So I should go for the ones place. 8 and 2. Which is small, children? 8 is small or 2 is small? Yes, 2 is small. So 42. After that, 48. What is left? 96 and 68. 9 is small or 6 is small? Very good. 68, then 96. All numbers are used. So here I have 57, 17, 18, 29, 46, 72. So I am going to underline the first digits. That is the tens places. Now 5, 1, 1, 2, 4, 7. Which is small? 1 is small. 1 I have 2 numbers. 7 and 17 and 18. 17 is small, children. 18 is small. Very good. 17. Then 18. Next. 5, 2, 4, 7. No doubt. It is 2. Next. 5, 4, 7. Which is small? 4 is small. After that, 5 is small, 7 is small, 5 is small. Next, last but not the least, 72. Like this, all our numbers are utilized. In the same way, you are going to write this third question and fourth question as your homework and arrange them in an ascending order following whatever steps I have told you. Now, let us see descending order. So, children, what is descending order? Descending order means big to small. So once again, we shall pick the numbers starting from 3. So here I have 61, 70 and here, okay, 22. So descending order means big to small. So once again, which place? Tens place. Ones, tens, hundreds. Sorry. Now let us see the tens place. Ones, tens, ones, tens, ones, tens,
What is in tens place? 6, 7, 2. So, descending order means big to small. So, which is a big number? 6, 7, 2. Which is a big number? Very good. 7. Now, 6 and 2. Which is a big number? 6. 2. Whatever it's left, it is 2. So, 74, 61 and 22 is the arrangement of descending order. Now, let us pick some more 4 numbers. Here I got it. Here I got it. Here I got it. It's 32, 59, 43, 39. Now once again let us see the tens place. Ones, tens. 3, 5, 3, 4. Which is big? 5 is big. So 3 and 3 and 4. Which is big? 4. 4 comes in the line. Now 3 and 3, when tens places are same, we should go for ones place. 9 and 2, 9 is big children, 2 is big. 9 is big. So 39, then the last one, 32. Let us see the last example. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 numbers. 68, 70, 75, 60, 38 are the numbers. Now, 6, 7, 7, 6, 3, which is a big number. 7 is a big number, but both has tens as same place. So, we should check ones place. 0 and 5, which is big? 5 is big. So, 5 comes in the line. Next, 70. Next, 6 is big children or 3 is big? Obviously, 6 is big, but I have 2 numbers here. 8 and 0, which is big? Very good. 8 is big and then followed by 0. And the last one, 38. So, this is the descending order of the given numbers. Now, let us see the textbook exercise. Arrange in descending order. 20, 68, 72, 95, 37, 17. I am underlining tens places. 2, 6, 7, 9, 3, 1, which is a big number. I think it's 9. 95. I think it is 9. So, 95. Next, 2, 6, 7, 3, 1. 7. 7 after 68. 2, 3, 1. Obviously 3. 2 or 1. Which is big children? 2. And the last one, 1. So this is the arrangement of descending order. Let us see the next one. Again underlining tens places. Okay. Now, 3, 2, 1, 6, 7, 8, which is a big number. 8. Next, 3, 2, 1, 6, 7, obviously 7. Then 6. 3, 2, 1. 3. Sorry. 2. And then last, 1. So children, 3 and 4 is your homework. Note it down and try to arrange them in descending order. So once again, children, ascending order means making the numbers arranged from small to big. Descending order, big to small.